Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about fuzzy text search in Postgres, as well as case-insensitive pattern matching. First of all, in this blog post by Brendan, we're going to talk about how you can go from not-so-fuzzy to the fuzziest search. The reason why you might care about fuzzy search is people misspell words, or you have American versus British English or other languages, or you may have creative spelling like hate with a triple Y. If you have user-generated content, you might care about fuzzy search. The easiest pattern matching in Postgres is like. I actually forgot this, but like supports two different ways of matching. What I usually use is the percentage character. You can use that to match against zero or more characters in a string. The other thing that you can also do is match against single characters of any value with an underscore. Like is cool. I use it a lot when I'm just looking at data. Like has companion ilike, which is case-insensitive search. We'll come back to different ways of doing that later as well. More sophisticated are regular expression searches. Postgres actually has a pretty good regular expression engine, a good amount of engineering that went into it. The way you can use regular expression searches in Postgres is either with the similar to keyword, or you can also use the tilde operator and its siblings to match against the regular expression. If you want to improve performance for like, you can use the text pattern ops and varchar pattern ops operator classes. This is what you specify when you run a create index command. You can use these in the case of a like that's left anchored. What that means is if the like has a wildcard, but it has the wildcard on the right side of the search string, then you can use the special operator classes to index that. The more sophisticated way of doing text search in Postgres is full text search. It breaks down the data into the individual lexemes. And then when you're searching, it also breaks down the search query into its individual portions that then match up against these stored lexemes. To improve Postgres text search performance, first of all, you want to store that data. You can use the new generated column features in Postgres to automatically generate a column off of your dataset. And then you index that column, that TS vector, with a JIN index. JIN indexes have some performance trade-offs because JIN indexes are inverted indexes. That means that it doesn't store one value per row, it actually stores multiple or zero values for each row. That, of course, means that maintenance as well as size are a bit more unpredictable. Another approach to search in Postgres is using the trigram extension. The way this works is you break the text into sets of three characters. Hello world, H-E-L, for example, one set, E-L-L would be the next one and such. That way, you can then match on things that are similar based on similar sets of trigrams. You can improve the performance of trigram search by creating a gist or JIN index. Usually, gist index is best. If you want to get more fuzzy, you can use Levenstein distance to match against things. Levenstein distance is essentially how many characters you have to change in order to turn one string into another string. You can see how this works pretty well for name searches. There isn't really a way to index that effectively, but what the author suggests here is there's actually other things that index well, so you can combine them. The soundex function looks at things that sound similar, like an with an e at the end or without an e. It's very focused on English language, so that is a limitation here. So you can do an expression index on that soundex function, and then you could combine that with Levenstein function to get a name search, for example. Another article that I was posted recently by Lawrence from the Cybertech team is on a related topic of case-insensitive search. There's different ways of doing that. The one that most folks are probably familiar with is using a lower function. You can also create a feature index on the lower expression. An alternate way of doing this is with the CI text extension. Instead of creating a column with the text data type, you create it with the CI text data type. You can actually then match against this column without doing anything special. Behind the scenes, it does a similar lower function call. The one thing to know about here, if it does regular expression matching, that's actually not case insensitive by default. You will still have to use that case insensitive operator. That might be a bit surprising if you don't watch out for it. Last but not least, pretty cool feature since Postgres 12 are case insensitive ICU collations. ICU is a new way of doing international sorting and matching of text because that's very locale dependent, depends on the country, depends on the language. There's all kinds of different rules for that. ICU represents these different rules and lets you create your collation based on a standard ICU locale. This references a case-insensitive ICU collation, and then you just reference this collation when you create your data types. In the query, you'd keep using your equality operator, nothing special there. And that's, you know, pretty sweet. Like is actually blocked here, and same for radial expression matches. Lawrence describes this a little bit more in this post. At the very end, Lawrence has done some performance comparison. This is surprising to me. I forgot the fact that lower is actually pretty slow. If you are doing explicit lower in your queries, running lower can have more than a tenfold difference between CI text and lower case-sensitive. ICU collations are actually a good trade-off here because they're slightly more standard than CI text. In general, it's good to be aware of those, even if you end up using lower because it's the simplest thing to do. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. If you're interested in indexing, we just uploaded the recording of our indexing webinar from last week to our YouTube channel. If you subscribe to the channel, you will also hear about next week's episode. Thank you so much and talk to you next week.